So let's take a look at a feature of the Finder called Spring Loaded Folders. Now this feature has been around for a while, but it's changed quite a bit. It works a little differently now. The basic idea is you want to put a file in a folder. So you can click on the file and drag it and drop it into the folder, and that works. But say you're not sure that's the right folder. You want to see what's inside first as you're dragging. If I were to drag over and wait, you could see it blinks and I go into the folder, but I'm still dragging. And now I can drop it. Not only could I leave it here, but I could leave it in a certain position here in icon view. So it has that advantage. One way to cancel this is hit the escape key. So I'm still dragging, still moving things around, but I hit the escape key on the keyboard. And sometimes it seems to spring back to where you originally were, which is nice. Sometimes it doesn't. Not quite sure why. Now a more useful case is if you need to go deeper. So say, for instance, there's a folder inside this projects folder. So if I were to drag milestones to it and drop it in there, it would only end up in the projects folder. I want it to go one level deeper. So I'll drag wait, it'll spring load, and now I can drag into this folder and drop it here. I'm going to Command Z to undo that, and we'll go back up. I'm going to Command up arrow to get here. So that's basically all Spring Loaded Folders does. Now it was more useful in previous versions of Mac OS where you could actually, it would open a second window, and if you left that second window, you know, dragged away from it, you would end up closing that one. You could try another. Here you kind of end up with this thing where you know, you drag in, and if it's not where you want, there's really no way to get back up. So you end up hitting the escape key and trying again. However, you can get different effects depending upon the view you're in. So here, for instance, in list view, if I go to drag, you'll see it opens up that as before. It's not much more useful. But in column view, it's very useful because I can drag and it will open it up in a column to the right, and I can move to another one and another one and even over here. So I have a great ability to be able to control where this stuff is going. So I can decide where I want it to go without ever having to release. So I can go down into this one and decide this is where it goes. So it works really well in column view. Now you do have one setting that controls this. It's in System Preferences and in Accessibility under Mouse and Trackpad. A long time ago this used to be in the Finder Preferences, but now it's here. So under Mouse and Trackpad you've got Spring Loaded Delay. You have a checkbox here where you can turn it on or off, and then you have Short or Long. So you can have a long delay. Let's try it with a long delay and see what happens. Let's go to the icon view and go up and say I want to drag this in here. It's got a little bit longer of a delay there, which may help you if you find you're accidentally doing this a lot, maybe slowly dragging across. Note that you can hit the space bar to immediately go in. The long delay isn't that long though, so I don't see it being that useful. But it's nice to know that that's there.